Hello everyone, welcome to the new series of Simplified. Today's topic of discussion is wetlands and coral reefs. The dimensions we are going to cover are introduction, regional distribution of wetlands, wetlands conservation and management rules 2017, and lastly Ramsar Convention. So let's begin with a brief introduction first. A wetland is an area of land that is either covered by water or saturated with water. A wetland is entirely covered by water at least part of the year. A wetland's water can also come from a nearby river or lake. Seawater can also create wetlands, especially in coastal areas. Wetlands are transition zones. They are neither totally dry land nor totally underwater. They have characteristics of both. Wetlands are defined under the Ramsar Convention as areas of marsh, fen, peatland or water, whether natural or artificial, permanent or temporary, with water that is static or flowing, fresh, brackish or salt, including areas of marine water, the depth of which at low tide does not exceed 6 meters. Moving on to the coral reefs now. Coral reefs are made up of thousands of tiny animals, coral polyps. Coral polyps are short-lived microscopic organisms which live in colonies. They secrete calcium carbonate. Polyps have soft body covered by a calcareous skeleton formed by calcium carbonate. When the coral polyps die, they leave their skeleton on which new polyps grow. The cycle is repeated for millions of years, leading to the formation of coral reefs. They are mainly of three kinds. Barrier reef, example is Great Barrier Reef of Australia. Fringing reef, example is Gulf of Kutch, Malabar Coast, etc. Atolls. Atolls are circular or horseshoe-shaped coral reefs, for example, Lakshadweep. Coral reefs are also regarded as rainforests of the sea. Corals live with algae in symbiosis relationships. This means the organisms cooperate with each other. The algae called zooxanthellae live in their tissues. The coral provides the algae with a protected environment and compounds they need for photosynthesis. In return, zooxanthellae supply the coral with glucose, glycerol and amino acids, which are the products of photosynthesis. The coral uses these products to make proteins, fats and carbohydrates and produce calcium carbonate. Point to be noted is that corals are animals because they do not make their own food. Zooxanthellae also provide corals with their striking colors. This symbiotic relationship is strongly dependent on the temperature of the surrounding water. As the water warms, zooxanthellae are expelled from a coral's tissue, causing it to lose its color and a major source of food. This process is known as coral bleaching. Coral reefs in India are Gulf of Kutch, Malabar Coast, Lakshadweep Islands, Gulf of Mannar, and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. In India, Lakshadweep reef is an example of atoll, while the rest coral reefs are fringing reefs. Now let's discuss about the regional distribution of wetlands. Currently, there are 46 Ramsar sites in India. First of all, we will see northern and eastern India. Under this, Jammu and Kashmir. The sites are Bhokersar, Surinsar, Mansar Lake and Vular Lake. In Ladakh, Sokar Wetland Complex that was declared in 2020 and Somoriri Lake. In Himachal Pradesh, Chandartal Wetland, Pong Dam Lake and Renuka Wetland. Dipor Bil in Assam and in Punjab, Bias Conservation Reserve, Harike Lake, Kanjli Lake, Keshopur, Miani Community Reserve, Nangal Wildlife Sanctuary and Ropad Lake. In Haryana, Sultanpur National Park that was declared in 2021 and Bhindawas Wildlife Sanctuary that was declared in 2021. Loktak Lake that is presently placed in Montreux's record in Manipur. Rudra Sagar Lake in Tripura and in Uttar Pradesh, Nawabganj Bird Sanctuary, Parvati Agra Bird Sanctuary, Saman Bird Sanctuary, Samaspur Bird Sanctuary, Sandhi Bird Sanctuary, Sarsai Nawar Jheel, Sur Sarovar and Upper Ganga River that is Brijghat to Naroda stretch. In Uttarakhand, Asan Conservation Reserve that was declared in 2020. In Bihar, Kabartal Wetland that was declared in 2020. In Odisha, Bhitarkanika Mangroves and Chilka Lake that was placed in the Montreux's record but later removed from it. West Bengal, East Kolkata Wetlands and Sundarbans Wetland. Next is Central and Western India. Under this category, Maharashtra with Lonar Lake and Nandur Madhameshwar, Madhya Pradesh with Bhoj Wetlands, Rajasthan with Keola Dev Ghana NP that is presently placed in Montreux's record and Sambhar Lake, Gujarat with Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, Thol Lake Wildlife Sanctuary that was declared in 2021 and Vadhvana Wetland that was declared in 2021. Next is South India. Under this, Koleru Lake in Andhra Pradesh and Kerala with Ashtamudi Wetland, Sastamkota Lake and Vembanad Coal Wetland and Tamil Nadu with Point Calimere Wildlife and Bird Sanctuary. Now let's have a look at the Wetlands Conservation and Management Rules 2017. Wetlands are regulated under the Wetlands Conservation and Management Rules 2017. Notified under the provisions of the Environment Protection Act 1986. Key provisions are Constitution of State Wetland Authority. Chairman is Environment Minister of the respective state. Setting up of National Wetland Committee. Secretary to MOEFCC is the chairman. And the following activities are prohibited. Conversion of wetland for non-wetland uses including encroachment of any kind, setting up of any industry and expansion of existing industries, manufacture or handling or storage or disposal of hazardous substances, solid waste dumping and discharge of untreated waste and effluents from industries, cities, etc. Now let's discuss about Ramsar Convention. It is an intergovernmental treaty that provides the framework for the conservation and wise use of wetlands and their resources. It was adopted in the Iranian city of Ramsar in 1971 and came into force in 1975. Since then, almost 90% of UN member states have become contracting parties and committed to the convention's three pillars. Work towards the wise use of all their wetlands. Designate suitable wetlands for the list of wetlands international importance and ensure their effective management. And last pillar is cooperate internationally on transboundary wetlands, shared wetland systems and shared species. So that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching.